from the district attorney's office. Yeah. It's pretty close. So, I'm Amanda, I'm the maid of honor, but also the sister to this beautiful bride. I've lived with Kelsi for over 2 decades, okay? 2 decades is a really long time for her to annoy the fucking shit out of me. And she also used to leave her cereal bowls everywhere. I know that this is
I can go from believing that you have my heart all the way to believing that you're deaf and far.
And I remember thinking there's no way she'll ever get married. Like, nobody would ever put up with that. And they moved in together, and she started picking up after herself. She started cleaning, and she started vacuuming.
It is all in the mystery, or fear of the unknown, that has me disbelieving.
I couldn't have picked a better man to compliment my little sister. I'll never forget when I asked Kelsi just a couple weeks ago, so when did the feeling of having a crush on Brandon actually end for you? And she said, I never had a crush on him. We've always just been best friends.
It's the act of believing that sets me
forget, like, that's what they're supposed to look for, someone who will just love you and who will just love you back. And that's the two of you. Your love is so effortless, you will forever be each other's best friends. And Brandon, may you have many, many more years of Judge Judy in your future.
Get this ring. You might have to go. Our best of you is in Colorado.
About finding a person you can live with, but finding that person you can't live without.
That's it.
Right? Well, apparently, these two have found that. My friend Brandon here, my buddy, my boy, you're my boy Blue. You found the person you can't live without. So everybody, let's raise our glasses. I don't have one right now, but whatever. And let's celebrate the happiness and the future to come of Brandon and Kelsi.
I said, hey.